On Medical Mondays, meet Nicole, a woman whose lifestyle was greatly impacted by uterine fibroids.
So the worst symptom is the pain. The most unattractive symptom is the bleeding. It limits your life. I liked kayaking, I liked swimming. You could do none of those things. It makes you cranky and angry and exhausted.
Uterine fibroids are benign tumors of the uterus. They arise from the muscle of the uterus and can start pretty early in life. Usually they begin sometime after a woman begins having her menstrual period, and then they can grow all throughout the reproductive life of a woman.
Fibroids are extremely common in women, especially between the ages of 35 and 50, and they're even more common in African American women.
Many women who come to the Fibroid Treatment Center come to us after they've already been seen elsewhere, and they've been told their only treatment option is a hysterectomy. Now, while hysterectomy is an excellent treatment for fibroids, it's by no means the only option. There are many ways to treat fibroids, and we believe patient preference is very important in this therapy.
At her first visit, Nicole saw a team of experts who laid out the pros and cons of various treatments, and in the end, let her decide what option was best for her.
Nicole had a variety of options available to her. She could have had surgery. She could have also had uterine artery embolization, even some of the potential radiofrequency ablation therapies, but she chose definitive surgery.
Nicole, who works for UPMC, felt confident in her medical team and the treatment option she chose.
Life after fibroid surgery is eye-opening. I no longer have to consider, do I have clothing? Do I have extra supplies? Am I going to be in pain that day?
Nicole's treatment really worked out well for her. It's really improved her quality of life.
Everyone who took care of me, to Dr. Guido and his staff, you have changed my life. Thank you.
For more information on uterine fibroids, visit our HealthBeat blog at upmc.com/healthbeat.